I'm Jessica Weiss, and this is my In the Bag video. I'm going to start out with my putters. This is a brand new Casey Glow AVR that is 175 max weight, and I basically use this just for my upshots, just to break it in. This is an old San Marino AVR. It's also a 175 Casey Pro, and it's my go-to putter. This is my old beat-up Casey Pro AVR, 175 max weight, and it's really good for Anheuser shots and Anheuser putts. We're going to move on to my mid-ranges. Here I got my overstable Glow Gator, max weight 175, really good for sidearm upshots or backhand overstable upshots. This here is my beadless Gator. It is also a max weight 175, and it's really good for my straight to right sidearm shots or my straight to left backhand shots. Really good in the wind and very consistent. Next, I got my brand new Casey Pro Glow Rock. It's a 175. And it's really nice. Can't wait to beat it in so that it's nice and flippy, and then I'll put a new one in the bag. This one right here, it's been through a lot, very old. It's an 11-time Casey Pro Rock, max weight 175. And I got this from a good old friend, Johnny Lissaman. It was a hand-me-down disc, and it's very understable. Here I got my three main sidearm discs. They're all Vulcans, two Star Vulcans, 168 and a 167. One of them's very old, like 3 years old, very understable, really good for hyzer flip shots. This right here is my Pop Top Champion Vulcan. It's a 170, and it's very reliable, straight to right sidearm shots. I don't usually throw it backhand. It's a very good sidearm disc, though. Right here I have all three of my Destroyers. This one's a brand new 162 Destroyer. I can't wait to figure it out and have it be one of my main go-to drivers. This one, I've had this one in my bag for probably about 2 years now. It's a 168 Destroyer, and I aced hole 7 at De La with this. This was my last ace right before the Masters Cup tournament. And this right here is my 168 Destroyer. It's a pop top Destroyer, so it's really overstable and good for in the wind. Good for headwind shots. This right here is my Star Wraith. It's almost like a Destroyer, but it doesn't quite go as far as my Destroyer. So if I don't want it to skip as much or go quite as far as my Destroyer, I throw the Wraith. It's a 168 and it's a pop top Wraith. This right here is my Excalibur. It's a 171. It's very overstable. I usually only use it for sidearm, but sometimes if I need a backhand to make sure it goes left, I'll throw my Excalibur. It's a very good overstable disc. And I love my Proline Leopard. It's very good hyzer flip shot or Anheuser turnover shots. It's a 175 max weight, and it's a Proline. It's really hard to find any Proline plastic anymore, so it's really special to me. This right here is a really good overstable fairway driver. It's a Thunderbird. It's a 170 Firebird Thunderbird, and it's very good for fairway overstable shots or turnover S shots. I really recommend a Thunderbird. Really good disc. And the last two I got here are the main basics that everybody needs is a Firebird. It's an overstable driver. I throw a 167 Firebird because if I throw a max weight, it won't go anywhere. So try and lighten it up so I can actually get it to get some wind under it and get it going somewhere. Very good overstable disc, very consistent. And this is my most recent disc in my bag. First time I've actually thrown a Valkyrie. It's a 160 Valkyrie, and I just put it in my bag for Tahoe for the high elevations, and I really like it. I really recommend the Valkyrie. It's a very good disc. And last but not least, I got the SoFly. It's really good for on the knee shots. Instead of putting your towel down or sticking your knee in the mud or the sticks, you got a SoFly. Put down and take a knee. It's great. Thanks a lot. That's my in the bag.
Hi, I'm Jessica Weiss, and I'm going to be demonstrating the sidearm today.
I'm going to start out with my Flippy Vulcan, and I'm going to show you the hyzer flip shot. A destroyer, and I'm gonna throw a flex S shot. Best thing to do is to most people hold it like this, but I throw a modified grip, pinch grip, and I'm going to turn it over to the left, and it's gonna come back and finish to the right. Here's my overstable disc. It's an Excalibur, and I use this just for my hook to the right shots. Oh boy. Best thing with a sidearm is to make sure that when you reach back, that you're all relaxed, and when you go forward, you want to go as fast as you can. You want to be slow and then go into it fast. With the sidearm, you just want to make sure to keep your disc flat, keep your palm flat, and make sure that you snap the disc with your wrist at the very end. With a sidearm, you really have to remember to keep everything compact and close to your body. You want to keep your elbow close to your side, and you want to follow through straight forward. So you're going to point, and then you're going to cock your wrist backwards, and then snap it forwards while you're keeping your palm flat. So one of the most important things when you're throwing a sidearm is your footwork. You gotta be very aware of how you're running up when you're going to throw. And with me, I like to start facing your target and step with your left foot first, then to your right foot, left foot, and then I jump and swing all of my weight at the very end. What I want to remember is when I plant my foot, I want to make sure that I plant and I throw my arm at the same time. It has to be in sync. very important to stay in sync with your body and your disc. So the basics for a sidearm is keep your elbow in tight at your side, keep your palm flat to the sky, and snap the wrist. I recommend running up slowly and then at the very last second being quick. A lot of people have a problem with either turning their disc too much over to the left or hyzering out and finishing to the right too fast. So the tip for that is to just snap it hard and flat and straight.